Hey everyone, so today we are going to see the fifth and the last type, at least in this playlist, on how to solve a problem on surface integral. And that fifth type is nothing but one of the very famous theorem in vector calculus, which is nothing but the Stokes theorem. So what does the theorem says? So let's try to understand the statement, and then I'm going to tell you the magic of this theorem. Okay, so one of the very good thing about this is you can play with any surface to solve one single problem. Okay, I will come to it later, but so be patient and watch the complete video. So it says that if you have a piecewise smooth oriented surface in a space, and the boundary, this is called as the boundary of S. So let me call the boundary of S as the curve C, where C is what? It's a piecewise smooth simple closed curve. So if you have such a scenario and you have a vector function which is a continuous function, that means it has its first order partial derivative also exist and they are continuous. So if you have such a vector function, then doing the surface integral of a curl is same as you do the line integral over C. Line integral of a function over C. So this is what the good connection that Stokes gave us. Okay, so before going towards the example, some small points to recall or remember. So Green's theorem connects line integral with the double integral. Gauss theorem connects surface integral with the triple integral, and Stokes theorem connects the line integral with the surface integral. So that's the first thing to observe. It connects line integral with the surface integral. Second thing to observe here is Stokes theorem tells it helps us to calculate surface integral of a curl of a vector field. Okay, it does not tell you to find how to find surface integral of a vector field. So given a vector field, you have to find the curl and then you can find its surface integral. Okay, and to find that, you can take the help of a line integral. So that's what the second important point one should observe. Now here, another point one should realize is, what is your C? It is the boundary curve of a surface. And one has to be careful while taking the boundary because one has to take care of the orientation. Regarding the orientation, I will come soon, but let me talk a little bit about the boundary. So suppose if I tell you that you consider a surface joining 100, 010 and 001 xyz axis. So if you join these three lines, what you get? A triangle. So what are the curve? Your curve C is nothing but it is union of C1, C2 and C3. So your C is C1 union C2 union C3. It's the union of three curves, three line segment. Now if I want to use Stokes theorem, I should have a surface. So what surface I take? What you do is you consider this closed triangle. So if you have a triangle over here, you just fill it up, and then you can see if you take this as a surface, solid triangle, then its boundary is nothing but this curve. Okay, suppose if you have, say, a circle, okay, so going in anti-clockwise direction, then which surface will I take so that its boundary will be a circle? One of the surfaces, you take a solid disk, then its boundary is nothing but a circle. So like this, you can, once a curve is there, if you can find a surface whose boundary is the curve, then you can think of applying the Stokes theorem. Okay, now, well, there are plenty of things to say, but let me come to the main point of this session. We will see that if you have a line integral, you can take different surfaces to compute that line integral. And the good thing about Stokes is you always get the same answer. So let's go to that example. So here is the example. So this is a vector field. I have found a curl for you. You can give a shot. This is what the curl is coming out to be: x minus y, x minus y 0. Our curve is what? It's a circle. And where is that circle? That circle is in z equal to 1 plane. Okay, and it is going in anti-clockwise direction. So this is z, x and y. And we need to do this line integral. So one way to go by line integral is you go by parametrization method. Well, we can give a shot. Well, many times it happens that if you go by parametrization, things might become difficult. And that's why we take the help of, if you recall my line integral lectures, we take help of potential field. But then here potential field does not exist because the curl is non-zero. So we can't use that method. Next, Green's theorem. You can't use Green's theorem because you have three components. So you have parameterization as one way. So can you do by parameterization? Yes. So if you do by parameterization, what is your r of t? It's a circle of radius 2. So 2 cos t, 2 sin t, and z is equal to 1. What is your r prime of t? It is minus 2 sin t, 2 cos t, and 0. And what is your f of r of t? What is your f of r of t? Wherever you have x, y, you put this, right? So f of r of t is nothing but it is x into z. So 2 cos t, 2 sin t, and 4 cos t sin t. And then you take the dot product, f of r of t, dot product with r prime of t, you have minus 4 sin t cos t plus 4 sin t cos t plus 0. And this is nothing but 0. So since f of r of t dot r prime of t is 0, and therefore when you do the line integral, is 0. So the answer for this is 0. Well, I did this by line integral so as to know the answer. But many times it might, and this was easy also, many times you will face the problem that if you're trying to solve by parameterization, things might become very difficult. Okay, so what to do? So the answer is you take help of Stokes theorem. Now if I want to take help of Stokes theorem, I should have a surface with me. So what surface you will take? So here you take the closed disk. Okay, so that is boundary will be the circle. Okay, so you take a closed disk. Now you need to parameterize the disk. So what is the parameterization of the disk? It is nothing but u cos v, u sin v, and 1, because it is a disk in z equal to 1 plane. Okay, now you do the normal calculation. You find r with respect to u and r with respect to v. What is r with respect to u? It is cos v, sin v, 0. What is r with respect to v? It is minus u sin v, u cos v, and 0. So now you find the normal vector, which is ru cross rv. Now question is whether you take ru cross rv or rv cross ru, because we know that we always have a two normal vector, and that's where the orientation comes into picture. Now see what this is given. This is given you that this is going in anti-clockwise direction. So what you do is, it's a nice trick which will help you. You walk along this curve, then your head and the normal vector should point along the same direction. So now when you're walking in anti-clockwise direction, your head is up. That means you should take this as the normal vector. That means RU cross RV. Suppose I would have said clockwise direction. So when you walk like this, obviously here it will be your legs. So your head will be down. So in that scenario, it will be RV cross RU. So this is head orientation will help you many times. Okay, so you walk along that curve, your head and the normal vector should point in the same direction. So now since here you are going in anti-clockwise direction, so your head is up, therefore this will be the normal vector. So you find RU cross RV. Well, I have done the calculation. So the answer here comes out to be 00u. Okay, so this is the normal vector. And now you need to solve this surface integral. So how do you solve surface integral? So by Stokes theorem, your line integral is nothing but surface of curl of f dot n ds. And what is this if I want to solve by parameterization? Here we have limits of uv, curl of f dot this. So curl of f is this. So in place of x and y, you put your uv. So what was my x? It was u cos v minus u sin v, comma u cos v minus u sin v, comma 0, dot product with n du dv. But when I take the dot product with n, the answer is nothing but 0. This into 0 plus this into 0 plus 0 into this. So this is nothing but double integration uv 0. And answer is coming out to be 0. Okay, so see, we got the same answer, 0 0. But now here you see the magic. Now suppose I took disk, right, as a surface. You might say I don't want to take disk. If I take and say inverted paraboloid, if I take, this is a circle, if I take an inverted paraboloid, then for this surface, this circle is also the boundary. So instead of taking disk as a surface, What if I take inverted paraboloid as a surface? Then for the inverted paraboloid also you have the same boundary curve. But don't worry, thanks to Stokes' theorem, you will again get the same answer. So let's try to do this problem by taking inverted paraboloid as a surface. So suppose if some of you will say, let me take this surface. Is there a problem? No, because this is the inverted paraboloid. And when I cut this with z equal to 1 plane, what is the intersection? When I cut it with z equal to 1 plane, your intersection will be a circle. And as you can see, when you cut this with z equal to 1 plane, you have phi minus x square minus y square equal to 1. You have x square plus y square equal to 4. The same circle which we took. So even if you take this surface, then for this surface S, its boundary is nothing but this circle. Okay, and since again the direction given is anti-clockwise direction, so you will have this outward normal. You won't take the inward normal. Okay, if they would have said clockwise direction, then your head is pointing down. In that case, you would have taken inward normal. But no, here you will take the outward normal. So that's how one has to see, okay, which orientation you have to take. So the same thing, you parameterize the surface. X equal to u, y equal to v, z will be phi minus u square minus v square. You find the normal vector, which is ru cross rv. So I have done the calculations for you. So otherwise you can also find it explicitly. And the answer comes out to be, so let me write down the answer. So it is 2u, 2v, 0. So that's what the normal vector comes out to be. Okay. Now what is your curl of f? Curl of f of uv, r of uv. So it will be u minus v 0. Right? So what is the line integral? By Stokes' theorem, f dot r dr is the surface integral of curl of f dot n. So if you take the dot product, it is 2 u square minus 2 uv plus 2 uv minus 2 v square du dv. Here are the limits of u and v. Now this goes away. This goes away. So 2 u square minus 2 v square. And if you take out 2 common, so let me erase this part. So if you take out 2 common, u square minus v square du dv. Now since whenever you have a circular thing, we always prefer polar coordinate. So if I go by polar coordinate, my theta goes from 0 to 2 pi. R will go from 0 to 2 because x square plus y square equal to 4. And here I have r square common. What is cos square theta minus sin square theta? It is cos of 2 theta. And r dr d theta. So here let me write r over here, r cube. And now when you integrate, this would be r 4 upon 4. Here you will have sine 2 theta. And when you put the limit 0 and 2 pi, sine 0 is 0, sine 4 pi is 0. Again the answer is 0. So if you don't want to solve this by line integral definition, if you take disk as a surface, then also you're getting the same answer. If you take inverted paraboloid as a surface, which paraboloid? Phi minus x square minus y square. Then only its boundary will be this. Okay, in that scenario also you're getting the same answer. And let's take one more surface. Suppose there are some who don't like disk, who don't like inverted paraboloid. Suppose they are liking the hemisphere. So you take the hemisphere, half of the sphere. Then question is, will you again get the same answer? Because for that also you are having the same curve. So which hemisphere you should take? You take surface as x square plus y square plus z minus 1 square equal to 4. If I take this hemisphere, so hemisphere with center 0, 0, 1 and radius 2. Will you also get the same answer? Let's check it out. Okay, so here, and you can check when my z is 1, what do I get? I get x square plus y square equal to 4. So same thing. So for this hemisphere, this curve is the boundary. So yes, I can apply Stokes' theorem. So let's try to parameterize the surface r of uv. You know how to parameterize the sphere. So it is the spherical coordinates. So 2 sine u cos v, 2 sine u sine v, and the center is 1, right? I mean the z component is 1, so 1 plus 2 cos u. And same, you find the normal vector ru cross rv. Again you are going in anti-clockwise direction, so your head is pointing upwards, so you will take the outward normal vector, not the inward normal vector. So you find RU cross RV. I have done the calculation. So the answer comes out to be 4 sine square U. So this is what the answer comes out to be. You can verify this, or you can just solve this. If you find any mistake, you can comment in the comment section. Okay, then you find this. What was our curl of F in terms of R of UV? So it was, if you remember, it was X minus Y comma X minus Y comma 0. So this minus this, it will be same. So 2 sine U cos V minus sine V, 2 sine U cos V minus sine V, 0. Now we take the dot product. So what is the line integral? Finally, by Stokes theorem, this is the surface integral of this curl F dot N. So if you take the dot product, what do you get? So let me write it down. So this is what you get when you take the dot product. Okay, I have done the calculation, so I have written directly. Again, you can take out this part common. So you can take out cos V minus sin V common, 8 sin cube U common, and you have cos V plus sin V. Okay, so it is double integration, 8 sin cube U is common. You have cos V minus sin V common. What is left? Cos V plus sin V. So what is A plus B into A minus B? It is A square minus B square. And now again, what is this? This is cos 2V. By double angle formula, this is cos 2V. 8 sin cube U. What is my V? Okay, so it's a hemisphere. So my U will be 0 to pi by 2. And V is theta. So 0 to 2 pi du dv. And you are done, because this integration is sine, and you put 0 to 2 pi, answer will be 0. So see, there's the magic of Stokes theorem. You wanted to find the line integral. You take any surface, the nice one, piecewise smooth oriented, whose boundary is again a piecewise smooth, simple closed curve. Then you can apply Stokes theorem and you will always get the same answer. So for a circle, we took disc, we took inverted paraboloid, we took hemisphere. You take any known surface, whichever you know, whose boundary is this circle in z equal to 1 plane, you will always get the same answer. The only thing is you have to take care of the orientation, but for that I gave you the nice idea of head. So just walk wherever your head goes, you take that as the normal vector. So yeah, that's the beauty of Stokes theorem. So if you understood this lecture, do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you.